So thank you for having us. We have some informational packets that we've been bringing around to all of the boards and committees that we've been speaking with.
The last time we were here in the fall, we talked about the whole process of the plan design grant that the Massachusetts Board of Library Commissioners matched funds with to go through this process. And we shared a lot with you in the fall. And tonight, we'd just like to share what the site, the plan might look like, and our two warrant articles that are going to be on town meeting floor. Previously, we talked about all the different options of sites that the Municipal Building Committee had recommended. The town, from the survey, wanted us to stay in the center of town, which the trustees and everybody else seems to agree with. And that we looked at the option of renovating our current building, but it, even with the footprints and the setbacks, all the different possibilities, it wasn't feasible to use that to bring and to try to bring that up to full accessibility. And I think you might have recalled we did look at, Russell School.
Just to clarify that last point, though, we did look at the possibility of expanding and renovating the current building, and what the architects told us was that truly the only feasible option with the church here, with the proximity to the two roads, was that we would need to build that way, and that it would, of necessity, go onto the footprint of the Hooker School. So we did look at that possibility, but it would have required removing that building to build that way. And so in the end, along with looking at the Russell School, looking at the green space behind the senior center, of the options that were put before us, building on the footprint of Hooker School was the most feasible, most beneficial for the library. It's all on one level. It's all completely accessible right out of the box. No elevators involved. It gives us enough room to also have at the back of the building room to expand should the need arise, you know, 20 years down the road, 30 years down the road. But the Board of Library Commissioners require that we be looking at least a 20-year planning horizon for this. And this building allows us, you know, to be added on to should the need arise down the road.
Right, and as you can see, it's on the middle street. It would be in line with the Goodwin compared to the sidewalk, the setback. And then you would come in this entrance, which is here. And as you can see, parking would be quadrupled. We're looking at 40 parking space compared to our 9. And then you would be able to come in this door here into the main lobby, and then onto the full library, which is fully open line of vision. So our staffing would stay relatively the same. We'd have a separate children's area with children's program area, teen room, and lots of space for our the stacks of our collection, a nice reading area, technology, computer resources, and small meeting rooms for quiet spaces, since we don't have that right now with everything all being in mostly one floor. And then this purple area is the meeting space that could hold about 75 people comfortably and could be accessed when the library is closed for if the planning board had a forum, or the library or any other town department or group had a forum or a program, they could use that when the library is closed and use the restrooms as well. So that's a real bonus that I know the town is needing more meeting space.
And just from the library standpoint, we receive, you know, 4 or 5 calls a week from people looking for meeting space around town. And we don't really have any kind of space that we can, you know, allow people to reserve. We can have people come in and meet informally around tables, but we can't reserve space for them because that disrupts, you know, our normal library operation. just members of the public, you know, group people from, you know, who's the last, we had a group of fabric artists that were looking for, I don't even remember where the person was from, but there was, you know, someone apparently in town looking to coordinate a meeting here as a central location for people coming from various directions. This is the feature of the meeting room is a standard feature of modern libraries. Now, all of the libraries and surrounding communities have meeting rooms that can be reserved.
But Hadley shouldn't be allowing public spaces for private enterprise. And what you told me is a fabric group.
These aren't paid activities. These would be free activities, just a place for people to meet.
Selling a product?
No, just to talk about, you know, on Wednesday night we have knitters. They come and meet around a table, and we accommodate that group of primarily Hadley residents that sit around the tables. They knit, they talk about knitting, they talk about town gossip, and you know, it's a place for them to meet and come together around a shared interest or enthusiasm. That's what the large meeting room allows us to do on a greater scale. We receive calls from Girl Scouts looking for places to meet when a space becomes unavailable that they normally meet in. And we try to accommodate them, but we can't do that all the time because it sometimes it's just not conducive to providing the service that we're here to provide. But we would like to have a space that allows people to have meetings, and you know, this allows us to expand the type of programming that we provide now.
Right. I mean, even now, the programs that we have for adults or children, if you've been in the library recently, it's very small. We can fit maybe, 10 adults. So this would be an opportunity for book clubs or historical presenters. Or we had recently the genealogy workshop. So there's many uses, as well as, like we said, if the town had forums or things not necessarily needing to be in the whole Hopkins, cafeteria, that you could use something like that. And the other key thing that a lot of people were requesting was quiet spaces. Now, with the children and the computers and the circulation desk all being within a space almost the size, it's not quiet, and it shouldn't be. There's a lot of activity. It's a community space where people meet and greet and interact. But this way, the children's space, if there is a program, it can be here, and people can use the computers and read and not be disturbed doing their work in that respect. And a program area that's for story hour and activities. And I think the biggest thing I really like about this is that it's fully accessible. There's accessible bathrooms. Any place in this library, everybody can go to. And as you know, our library in many of our town buildings is not open that way. And since the library is for everybody, of all ages and needs, we'd really like to open the doors to everybody to come in and feel comfortable. So we have two warrant articles. Warrant Article 20 is asking the town to authorize the site using the Hooker School site, but also contingent upon us getting the Massachusetts Board of Libraries construction grant, because we would not obviously knock down a building unless we had the funding and things in place. And then the second article is Article 21, which is for the town to say, yes, we like the plan, keep moving along with this process, apply for that construction grant. That construction grant is due January of 2017. We wouldn't know until June of 2017 whether we even got it. And then we would go back to the town with how much it's going to cost, what the financial plan would be, and then go from there to actually the construction. But that wouldn't even happen till 2 years out.
2019 at the earliest.
At the very earliest.
And it's very unlikely that that would be the case.
This looks like to me that you opened the barn to the door, chased the horse out, and then you're chasing him. I want to know what this thing's going to cost before you even apply for nothing, before you go for this article. what's going to happen to the senior center? What's going to happen to the seniors?
Right.
What's going to happen to us? There's no room in the town hall. We're not going out on the street for you.
Right.
I'll tell you that right now.
Well, there's a, to answer those two questions there about what's happening with the whole community, it is. We're like a catalyst to get things rolling. The Municipal Building Committee has been looking at all the buildings, trying to figure out what buildings money can go into to make them feasible for the departments that are using them, and then also thinking out 20 years, like our plan is for what the future of a library should be in 20 years. So there is an article the Municipal Building Committee is putting out. I believe it's going to be Article 10 that is requesting funds for an OPM to do to work with the senior center and park and rec.
Owner's project manager.
What?
Owner's project manager.
Yeah, that
sort of a building advisor to help the process of doing
required.
the design studies, the feasibility study for the departments that we'll be utilizing.
So you want to knock this building down before?
No. So there would be a plan in place and a hopeful, by the time any of that would be done, of where the senior center would be, what the park and rec situation will be, because we know they're selling North Hadley Hall, so they're looking for space, where other departments such as yourselves, Historical Commission, where the, I know it's not called Tampa.
I'll tell you, I personally...
That would have to be go somewhere else, too. But that's what the Municipal Building Committee and the Select Board have been working on together, and we've been in communication with them since the start. And because we're on a specific timeline in order to take this opportunity for this grant money to get a construction grant, it only happens every 5 years, and that's not even guaranteed. So in order to reach this construction, be able to apply in January, that's why things are rolling. And I don't think of it as we're shooing people out or making people do things. I'm thinking this is a good thing for the town. The seniors deserve a better space, something that's suitable for seniors. And Park and Rec deserves a space. You deserve a space. Everybody deserves something. And I know it comes all from one pot and one part of, you know, that we all have to fund. But nothing has been done in the last several years to any of the buildings or to improve space for some of these departments. And something needs to be done. And that's why the town voted to have a Municipal Building Committee, to have these studies done for these buildings, find out what every department needs. And they're trying to move forward with it. The library is in a different situation because we have this opportunity to have help. There was a $50,000 opportunity. We did the matching of $25,000. The town voted for that to get this far. And in order to do the construction grant, which would be 54% of this building, and if we don't take this opportunity, we might be leaving that $2 million or so on the table.
We're working with the architects to get. We hope to have the the cost estimators, numbers in hand by now. We will have them ahead of town meeting. We just don't have them yet. What we're looking at is a building that will be in the ballpark of $5 million. The MBLC will fund for a project in that range up to 54%, maybe actually slightly more than that from the last meeting that I went to. We have a capital campaign committee that's coming together to raise funds. We're hoping to raise 10% of the total cost, which would be $500,000, which leaves 36% to the town. And that that would be for a project in the $5 million range. That would be under $2 million.
What's the square footage of that building?
I think it's 11,500 square feet.
And it's a conservative compared to other towns our size.
It's very compact and very efficient.
Mm-hmm. I'll tell you what I need from you guys.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What's going to cost me and the elderly people that you want to paint this pretty picture, new senior center, new this, new that. What is this going to cost us for taxes?
Well, from what I understand,
after everything's done and said, mm-hmm. they spent how much money putting a new roof on here? They want to knock I don't know who's doing the planning around here, but everybody's going to me in a different direction. There was a building committee. They were supposed to analyze all the buildings, mm-hmm. bring up our existing buildings up to a safe standard, which is not being done. They're putting a little money here, a little money there. Then now they're going to spend more money for new buildings. There's not going to be no more money to maintain all the other buildings.
Did you say $5.4 million to build it?
Pardon? No, maybe five.
I'll say five.
They don't. They're just saying that they don't. Have no,
yeah, we don't have
the final
cash,
number,
right.
But we're
don't have no.
You said 11,400 square feet.
I believe 11,500 square feet is.
How much for a new senior center?
That requires the senior center to do the study to actually.
Why don't you do it? You're knocking their building.
I'm not an expert in senior services,
right.
But
well,
you do have
you
a very
hire someone to do it.
You do have a very qualified senior services director. Who I believe is going to be undertaking
so
that.
So you're
going
to bring that? They don't have no money in their budget for that. Where are they going to get that money?
That's what
I believe. That's what their
Article
request for
is.
OPM is on the warrant.
I don't know. It seems to me you guys are the big spenders from the east, and I'll tell you something. I don't like this at all. Okay. There's a building committee. You guys jump in there. If you can't get your grant now, get it 5 years from now. Let's do some long-term planning and good planning. I was on the school building committee with Jimmy, and I was on the safety complex committee. I argued with those people, do this, do that, brick veneer, oh, we can't do it, let's go back to town meeting. I says, when they occupy it, it's gonna be to capacity. What happened? It was to capacity. Mm-hmm. And here we're going doing the same thing over again, and I'm not gonna be quiet about this. I'll tell you right now, you guys are off base. You jumped the gun, because the rest of the town, let the town take care of the town. Well, there's more important things in this town to me than a library. Well, there's public safety, there's fire, there's highway, and then the seniors. What's gonna happen to them?
Well, the seniors are following their-
I'm gonna tell you, when you're done with your snowball, you're gonna be doubling our tax rate.
Well,
I'll tell you right now, and your programs, you're not even saying anything about that. You're building this big building. You're inviting everybody from East Bum Hole or wherever they're coming from. I don't know. You know, you got computers today. I never was in that library in my life. What the heck? And the rest of my life, I'll never go in there. And how many people actually, you know, with the computers and everything else today? To me, that's just a waste of taxpayers' money. We need to spend money on infrastructure. Nobody even, none of you folks, I went to the selectmen, here we got sewer underground, water underground, drainage, that is total disaster in this town, and we're building libraries. I don't know what you guys are thinking of. You think it's a joke? Don't be laughing.
No, I am not laughing. I value your opinion.
Yeah.
And I feel like there's a group of community members who use our library and our
That's not
the
but
numbers
a social
have gone
plan,
up.
As far as I'm concerned.
Well, it's prioritizing.
If I might provide several numbers, the last fiscal year, we had 17,000 patron visits. 17,000, that averages 400 to 500 per week.
You're not providing us as taxpayers what it's going to cost us.
We are trying to provide that information to you as
you do that before you even get to town meeting.
That's
the
plan.
Right. The select board has talked about how the some of our deaths are ending, and this will be in the same time of.
So, what do you think? That's free money?
No, I would say that this is what we were told, that they feel like by adding projects that
they could take all that money that mm-hmm. with the debt being excluded and spend that all in our infrastructure, and that would be a smart and wise decision to do to protect this town for the future. Which is much more needed, that serves the whole town, than a library that serves a special group and not a big group. We got the big town of Hadley, all the people in this town, and a lot of elderly people.
Right, and
they're complaining now to pay by oil, pay for pills, and never mind pay their taxes. This, to me, this is like Amherst did 40, 50 years ago. Drove the young people out and drove the elderly out because they built all kinds of things like this.
Can I tell you a story about my mom? She's 84. She lives in a town, Salisbury. They just had a brand new library put in, and it's not a town that has a lot of money. The town is there more than they have ever been there. My mom goes there. She sits in a nice, comfortable place with air conditioning in the summertime and a fireplace in the wintertime. She lives alone, so this is an opportunity for her to see people and socialize, to read the local paper and magazines that she can't afford to just get on her own every day. This is not a library that's just for a certain amount of people and certain age group of people. It's from any person in our community, and everything is free.
What I just said to you went right
and
over your head.
No, I understand everybody has their priorities of what's important, and that's why it goes to the town meeting for them to vote for what's important to them. I believe, and the library is important, I'm not saying that the things you were just explaining are not important. That's not what I'm here for. I'm not on the sewer commission or the Board of Health, other groups that would be putting these proposals. I'm here to share a vision for the town. It's a positive thing. It's a place where people can go and be a part of our community. And people have different opinions, and that's what happens.
Well, you're going to hear my opinion, because you're concerned with just one building. I'm concerned with the entire town in its entirety, the schools, everything. And they're not being addressed. This town is in a lot of trouble. They got a very poor maintenance program. And I'm telling you that I was on that sewer commission, and I started a program, Cameron the Lines, and we're headed for disaster on Route 9. That we're gonna have collapses. They spent $250,000 on Lorana Drive for a little section. When they have a break on Route 9, and that's gonna happen, it's gonna be $1 million for that. And that's just a little section. Mm-hmm. So until they do all that, and they do that first, because we need the sewer to take care of the business, the homes, we need drinking water, which the lines have been in there, they're ancient. How many hydrants don't work? They gotta be fixed. Nobody touches the drainage in this town. This town is a flat town, and nobody's doing nothing. Everybody wants their special interest buildings. I'm telling you, you guys got to cut this nonsense out. That's what this is, nonsense. You start looking at the overall town, and I care about this town. I've been involved over 30 years in town government, and everybody is just passing the buck and kicking the can down the road. That needs to be stopped. And you guys can't jump ahead. Jump right into the game. There's a building committee to analyze all the buildings, to come up with a recommendation, and you guys jump right in the game. Well, we need a new library. What about all their planning?
Well, we worked in consultation with the Municipal Building Committee.
No, you jumped in. You jumped into it. You interjected this. They didn't put this on town meeting warrant. You did.
That's true. But yeah, they are in support of the project. And we have been working with them ever since their building was formed. We had a library trustee at every single one of their meeting. We've had a select board member on our planning and design, and we had a municipal building committee member as part of our planning and design. We've tried to be very transparent and working with other committees and meeting with the senior center community. And we're
trying. Did you tell those seniors what it's going to cost them in their taxes?
That we don't
not
know
just tell them, oh, you're going to get a new building. Oh, that's nice. I'd like a new building. I'd like everything new. But the bottom line is what it's going
to
cost.
They have to do the study to find out what their building will cost, what their needs are. That's not
not
the
just them. I do, too.
It's about $500 per person in Hadley over the life of the project. I just took the $2.5 million and divided it by 9,000.
Well, yeah, that's just one item.
Yeah, I know.
That's one. Add all the other ones. Yeah. They got over $100 million worth of projects that they're playing with.
Well, the select board and the town administrator were working with those numbers and the
The town administrator, I wouldn't believe one thing he says for numbers.
Okay.
Every week is a different
Well, we appreciate your time.
This is not kind of being...
We just appreciate your time and for us to share our information.
What it's worth, it's a beautiful building. It is.
We agree with that.
If it's with the landscape and the issue as well, I'm not going to afford it.
Well, thank you.
Okay, you're welcome, and we'll see you at the town meeting.
Go to town meeting.
I'll be there.
Right, and we'll be able to answer more questions for the community members too.
You better come up with some good answers.
And we would like to you know, welcome you to come into the building to see the conditions under which we provide service now. It is an essential town service, and we are constrained by the space that we're in. So I would be happy to meet with any of you to show you the building, to talk about the issues, and you know, whether you agree or disagree, I would be happy to see any of you there.
Why don't you call John Kerry up and ask him to put up the other $2.5 million and name it after him?
Thank you.